Hello, my name is Mike Putoff, and I'm a professor and currently serving as the director of the St. Ambrose University Physical Therapy Department. Well, this isn't the graduation event you imagined 2.5 years ago. Normally, we'd be together for a nice dinner and recognition of our graduates. Then on Saturday, you'd be hooded at our commencement ceremony. Of course, the reason we are watching this video is because of COVID. I think we can all agree that COVID has caused so much pain and agony. And while a canceled graduation ceremony is not the worst thing that COVID has done, we would have preferred to be together right now celebrating our graduates. We do hope that you're able to find your own way to celebrate with family and friends. But let's focus on the positive and try to forget about COVID for a moment. To our graduates, the class of 2020, this has been a life-changing time. It may feel like yesterday you came to St. Ambrose University for your applicant interview. You probably still remember that excitement from your first day of class. And no matter how hard you've tried to forget the anxiety of testing, you might still have an occasional nightmare about showing up late to a practical exam. But here you are at graduation. Think about how much you've learned, how much you've grown, and all the individuals you have met. You are very familiar with faculty telling you you're ready to treat patients. Well, now you are a doctor of physical therapy. You are prepared to enter the profession of physical therapy and enrich the lives of your patients. While this video does not take the place of a commencement ceremony, we're excited to share it with you. You'll hear from Dr. Kathy Lampe, our commencement speaker and recipient of the Class of 2020 Special Recognition Award. Then there'll be a special message from each faculty member before we read your names. We do want to recognize students who have won scholarships and awards over the last 2 years and announce the Physical Therapy Department Student Scholarship Award. Then you'll hear from Cody Burley and Nick Guzman, your student speakers. I do encourage you to watch the Charge to the Graduates from Sister Joan Lisinski, our university president. Her message is important and a great way to end your graduation celebration. The link to her talk is in the video description below and has been shared with you by email. Now, I encourage you to grab your favorite beverage or snack, sit back, and enjoy the Class of 2020 virtual celebration.
Hello, everyone, and good evening. My name is Colton Rule, and I am the graduation chair for the Student Physical Therapy Organization for the Doctor of Physical Therapy Class of 2020. First, I want to take this opportunity to thank our faculty and staff for everything that they've done this year. I know that this has not been an easy year for anybody, and I know that the pandemic has created a lot of extra stress and work for everybody, so I want to say thank you for all of your hard work to ensure that we had the best education and clinical experiences possible given the circumstances. I think that this year has really made us all think about what is most important to us, and I know that it has made me realize what is most important to me, and that is friends and family. And I hope that all of my peers are able to watch this video with their loved ones, and if they're not, I'm sure that they're still there in spirit or in FaceTime spirit. So I want to take a moment to thank the family and friends of all the graduates of the Doctor of Physical Therapy Class of 2020. And so our guest speaker is Dr. Kathy Lampe. Dr. Lampe taught in the physical therapy program at St. Ambrose from 1994 up until this last spring. And you can't deny the significant impact she's had on our program. She's instructed or was involved in the instruction of 10 classes throughout our time in the PT program. And out of all those classes, the most important class that she taught us was Issues in Patient Care, which is a class that teaches us about the emotional side of physical therapy and how important it is that we are able to connect with our patients on an emotional level in order to better understand the issues that they are dealing with and the struggles that they are going through so that we may provide the best possible care. You want to talk about real-world applications of a class, look no further than Issues in Patient Care in 2020. Not only was Kathy a great professor and a pillar in the Doctor of Physical Therapy program, she's also referred to by a lot of us as the mom of our class and the mom of our program. Someone that you can always come to talk to about any issues that you might be having, the stress that classes might be causing, or someone that always has a lot of M&Ms in her candy jar in her office. And I think I speak for everyone in our class when I say that Dr. Lampe, most represents our family and friends at a time when we may have been very far from them. So I take great pleasure in introducing our guest speaker, Dr. Kathy Lampe.
Thank you, class of 2020, for inviting me to do your graduation speech. I appreciate the invitation. And thank you as well to all the family, significant others, friends, St. Ambrose faculty, staff, and administration for supporting this wonderful class in the pursuit of their physical therapy degree. I have been fretting about what to say for this speech for quite a while, basically ever since they asked me to do it. My concern was enhanced when I was asked to keep it short, like 5 to 8 minutes. Class, you know what it's like for me to talk to you. I can kind of go on and chit-chat a lot in class and lab. But I'm going to try to keep it short, and I'm going to fall back on what I know as a retired physical therapist and a faculty person. I'm going to provide you with an objective to meet after this lecture or speech and an acronym to kind of help you remember this challenge I give to you for the objective. Now, typically nobody remembers graduation speeches, but an acronym might help. And acronyms for the family and friends, they're kind of a way for the PT students to help them remember information for exams and practical tests. So when I was getting ready for this talk, I was looking for inspiration in my everyday life. And this past summer, I actually saw a sign, literally a sign, in a PT department. And I decided that this sign was definitely a sign that I should utilize this as my objective for you for your profession as a physical therapist. So this quote is often attributed to Martin Luther King. And the quote is, "If I cannot do great things, I can do small things in a great way." And when I saw this quote, it stuck in my mind, and I got thinking, what does great mean to me? And what might great mean to these students? So another thing that I did in the spring, because I knew I was going to be doing this talk, is I was also kind of sneaky. I had this class do some extra credit to go back on one of their test scores. And the extra credit was basically, what kind of advice would you provide your fellow classmates when you graduate and become physical therapists? So in this sneaky way, I'm using some of their insights and knowledge and some of my own insights and thoughts as a PT to help define what GREAT is. So I'm going to go through the acronym GREAT, and I'm going to give you various words to maybe help you remember how to do great things in a small way and or a great things in a large way, too, if you're able to. So let's start off with G. Be genuine with everybody that you encounter in your lives. Class, I know that you figured this out after being on your clinicals recently. You know that people can see through you when you're not being genuine. Be genuine, be kind, be caring, be empathetic, be the wonderful people that you are. Be genuine with everybody you encounter. The other G word is gratitude. Please be grateful in this time. Gratitude can help you manage your lives. I always count my blessings as a person. That's how I keep my life in balance. It's how I manage my stress and my worries. I encourage you to before you go to sleep at night, to count your blessings and be grateful for all the wonderful things we do have, even in the midst of a pandemic. I know I'm thankful for becoming a physical therapist. I've never wanted to be anything else, and I'm extremely grateful for having been able to teach this class from beginning to end. So G, be genuine and be grateful. The other one is grace. Now, I'm going to attribute this next piece of information from Maddie, who's in this class. She had a difficult situation on clinicals, and it taught her to give herself grace. And I think you should give yourselves grace and other people as well. So this is kind of a paraphrase quote from Maddie, and I did get her permission to use this. So Maddie basically said something to the effect, "I can't solve everyone's problems. I can't control every complex situation. What I can do is give every patient in every situation my best effort and my best possible care to make a positive impact in their lives." This class of 2020 is full of students just like Maddie. This is wonderful. This is why they're going to be great physical therapists. So G, be genuine, be grateful, and give yourself grace. R, respect. All right, class, here's a question, pop question in the middle of the lecture speech. Do you remember what your number one ethical principle is? I asked you this in Issues in Patient Care, and the room was kind of dead silent. But I think now you guys have an understanding. Our number one ethical principle, just to kind of paraphrase again, is to respect all people. And if you respect everyone you encounter, both professionally and personally, you will be a great physical therapist and a great person. If you respect people, you're being person-centered, and person-centered care is very, very important. So R is respect. R is also reflect, reflection. As you go through your career, reflect on how you practice as a PT and how you interact with other people. Admit and learn from your mistakes. Remember, we all make mistakes. I'm still making mistakes after 30 plus years of practicing. I make mistakes in my personal life, and I made mistakes in my professional life. Learn and grow from your mistakes. So reflect on everything that you do. And the last R is resilience. I think every single one that's watching this talk or going through the pandemic right now has had to develop resilience. So tap into your reservoir of resilience for the rest of your lives and your career. It will be very helpful for you in many situations that you encounter. So R is respect, reflect, and be resilient. E is engage. Become engaged and interact with all the people and the families that you encounter, everybody in your personal and professional life. Accept any challenges and opportunities that come your way. Engage in that. Step out of your comfort zone. Does that sound familiar from the ClinEd office? Get involved. Ask questions. Pursue new ideas. Engage in research or quality improvement in your workplace. Anything that will keep you engaged and excited in what you do. Don't fall into that cookie cutter PT rut. Please don't do that. Always strive for being excellent. Use evidence-based practice. Become engaged as a person and as a PT. The other E is enrich. So one of the main reasons I came to St. Ambrose is because the St. Ambrose mission really, truly speaks to my heart. To paraphrase the St. Ambrose mission, we here at St. Ambrose are involved in enabling our students to develop intellectually, spiritually, ethically, socially, artistically, and physically to enrich their own lives and to enrich the lives of others. These graduates in this class have completely enriched my life. I'm so grateful I got to know them. Now it's the time for them to go out and enrich the lives of others as wonderful PTs. So E is engage and enrich. Now for A in great. I want you to be an advocate the rest of your lives as a professional. Be an advocate for patients, families, communities, our profession. Step up for the people that need help. Help your communities, help our profession. And the other A is advance our profession. So that kind of ties into this advocacy. As I retire, you're entering into the physical therapy profession. I challenge you to advance our profession for the benefit of everybody that we serve as physical therapists. I know you will carry this profession forward into the future. I am confident that our profession is in very capable hands with this class. So A is advocate and advance. T is share your time. Give back to others. Give back to, in your community, in your profession, and everywhere else. I've tried to give back my time to others. Go that extra step. Go that extra mile. So share your time. The other thing I want to encourage you to do with the T is share your talents. There's a wise young person in this class, too. I mean, all of you are wise young people in this class. But Caitlin gave me permission to use a quote she posted on the clinical education Blackboard discussion. Her quote is, because patients don't need me to regurgitate what I learned in a lecture, they need me to use my expertise to make a good decision for what I believe is the best for them individually in their current situation. So don't hoard your gifts of time and talent. Share yourself and your abilities with others. And Caitlin's quote is a perfect example of what wonderful PTs these students are going to be. So here, let's review, because that's kind of what we do in lectures. GREAT, the acronym. G, genuine, gratitude, and grace. R, respect, reflect, and resilience. E, engage in everything that you encounter and enrich the lives of yourself and others. Be an advocate, A, and advance our profession. T, share your time and talents with everybody you encounter. Now I want to bring this little talk to a full circle here. The first time I ever gave a graduation speech, it was at my high school graduation. And no, class, I'm not going to tell you what year that was. I'm going to keep the secret of my age. But I wanted to kind of end this talk the same way I ended my graduation speech in high school. I want to honor my grandpa, Tom McDonald. My grandpa emigrated from Ireland when he was a teenager to start a new life. And I'm very proud of my Irish ancestry. So I'm going to give you an Irish blessing. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face, the rains fall soft on your fields, and until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. It has been an absolute honor and privilege to teach at St. Ambrose and to have these students be part of my life. Now go meet the objective I set before you. Do great things, both in small and large ways, because I know you guys can do this. I believe in you, so please believe in yourselves. You're going to be amazing physical therapists. So thank you for inviting me to talk, and please keep in touch with St. Ambrose and with me. You have my email. Take care. Thank you.
Hi, class of 2020. Congratulations to everyone. You know, I'm fortunate enough to every year to be the professor who has everyone in class that very first day of PT school, bright and early Monday morning, everybody with shiny faces and excited to get started on PT school. And one of the best things about graduation is normally I get to see how much each of you have grown and matured since that very first day. And I miss seeing all of you and being able to spend time with you, but I know that all of you have matured and grown so much over these last 2.5 years, and you can all be very, very proud of everything that you've accomplished along the way. I know we all look forward to hearing about all your accomplishments, both personal and professional, in the future as well. And hopefully we can maybe get together at some point and catch up. So I hope you all keep in touch. And again, just congratulations to everyone.
David Carius. David is from Coal Valley, Illinois. He went to undergraduate school at Luther College, where he majored in biology. David would like to give a shout out to the people who have housed him and fed him over the last 27 years, acknowledging that it may have been a bit longer than they had bargained for. Sarah Gettle. Sarah is from St. Louis, Missouri. She went to undergraduate school at St. Ambrose University, where she majored in exercise science. After graduation, she plans on working either in the St. Louis area or possibly as a traveling therapist. Sarah would like to thank her family for supporting her and helping her stay focused on her dreams. Emily Mangold. Emily is from Peoria, Illinois. She was an undergraduate student at Greenville University, where she majored in exercise science. Her plans after graduation are yet to be determined. Emily would like to thank her parents, her family, and her husband for supporting her so well along this journey.
Cody Burley. Cody's from Davenport, Iowa. He attended Wartburg College, majoring in neuroscience and Spanish. After graduation, he plans to spend time in Maquoketa, Iowa, before leaving for Atrium Health Neurologic Residency in Charlotte, North Carolina. Thanks to my old man for putting up with PT talk at the dinner table for the last 2.5 years. To my mom for keeping my sanity high and hunger low through it all. To my brother, sorry for his obnoxiousness 24 years later, and I'm still apologizing on his behalf, for being my study buddy and reminding me to have fun. And thanks to all of you for putting up with my terrible dad jokes, for the pity laughs that came with them, and for making this experience for an experience for the books. You all made dad so proud. Alexandra Cortade. Alex is from Somerset, Wisconsin. She attended St. Ambrose University, majoring in exercise science, and after graduation plans on working in the La Crosse, Wisconsin area. Thank you. Shannon Hara. Shannon is from Elburn, Illinois. She attended St. Ambrose University, majoring in exercise science. After graduation, she plans on working at the Sports Rehabilitation Center in Midtown Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you to my family and friends who have all supported me throughout the program. I couldn't have done it without your support and encouragement. Thank you to my classmates for becoming like family and giving me some of my favorite memories at SAU. Thank you to our professors for sharing your knowledge with us and always encouraging us that we know this stuff. Thank you to all the families that provided me housing and support during my internships. Gabrielle Weber. Gabby's from Chatsworth, Illinois. She attended Illinois Wesleyan, majoring in psychology. After graduation, she plans on working in the Bloomington Normal area. I would like to thank my family and friends for all they have done to help me reach this point in my education and future career.
Congratulations, class of 2020. It's so exciting. You've made it to graduation. I know on that first day it was a little scary, but you've all managed to come through and do a great job. COVID's been a little bit tough, but you are able to be flexible and adaptable with online learning, as well as moving into the clinic. I'm excited to welcome you to the field of physical therapy as a colleague. Always feel free to stop in, grab some candy, and just say hello. Take care. Anna Atkinson. Anna is from Traer, Iowa. She received her exercise science degree from St. Ambrose University. Her post-graduation plans include working in the Quad Cities. Anna stated she would like to thank her husband, family, and friends for supporting her the last 2.5 years. Erin Dunn. Erin is from Clinton, Iowa. She received her undergraduate degree in exercise science at St. Ambrose University. Following graduation, she plans to work at Advanced Physical Therapy located in Clinton, Iowa. Erin wants to thank Kathy Lampe for her dedication to the program and for helping students become competent physical therapists throughout her years of teaching. Megan Forsman. Her hometown is Longview, Washington. She had her undergraduate degree in health sciences from Carroll College. Her post-graduation plans include pediatric physical therapist in Cedar Rapids. Megan wrote she wanted to thank her mom and dad for teaching her to be a lifelong learner and getting her to where she is today. She also wanted to say thank you to Danny Starr for joining me on this crazy journey through PT school.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm so excited for you. I wish we could be celebrating in person, but we can't, thanks to that nasty old COVID. But I will bet that you have found pathology even more useful now, that you just thought it was a bunch of old lectures about viruses and other things, and that you've used it a lot. But seriously, you guys have had to really adjust to a lot. I don't think there will be anything at you in your career that will be able to throw you off course. You've adapted to online learning, had your clinicals adjusted, missed out on sharing graduation with some of the most important people of your lives, meeting up with your classmates. For that, I feel terrible for all of you, and I hope we can all get together and do something great in the future. But in the meantime, good luck in your careers. You're going to make terrific therapists. Be sure and pop a bottle of bubbly or have a glass of nice red wine for me, and I will be seeing you soon. Congratulations again, class of 2020.
Nick Guzman is from Fort Madison, Iowa. He received his undergraduate degree from Central College, majoring in exercise science. After graduation, Nick plans to work at Fort Madison Community Hospital as a generalist. He would like to thank Little Caesars and the 25% for being there for him when he needed it the most. He couldn't have done it without you all. Olivia McDonough is from Cambridge, Illinois. She graduated from St. Ambrose University with a degree in exercise science. After graduation, she plans on working in the Quad Cities area. She would like to thank her entire family, her boyfriend Keegan, her best friends and classmates for their support and love throughout her whole college experience. She also would like to give one huge thank you to Barb Ehrman for being the best undergraduate advisor, graduate advisor, and mentor throughout her whole college career. Daniel Starr is from Cedar Rapids, Iowa. He graduated from the University of Iowa with a degree in human physiology. After graduation, he plans to get a job in the outpatient setting, find a place to live that isn't his parents' house, and get married. He'd like to share a special thanks to his fiancée, Megan, who has been there with him every step of the way and who has helped motivate him to be a more empathetic and compassionate person, as well as kicking him in the rear to study for exams. Madeline Youngers is from Long Grove, Iowa. She graduated from St. Ambrose University with a degree in exercise science. After graduation, she plans on working in the Quad Cities area. She would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her throughout the program. She would not have been able to do it without all of the love and support.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on your accomplishments. You put in a lot of hard work, a lot of time, a lot of energy, and now you get to enjoy it. I'm sorry we can't be meeting together. We're having to do it this way, but again, it is really nice to know that you guys have all completed this, and congratulations to all of you. There's been a lot of changes in this past year. You guys have done a phenomenal job of adapting to it and really being able to go with the flow and still continue your learning process. So thank you for all the work and adaptability you've done. I now look forward to working with you as professional colleagues. Hopefully I'll be working alongside of you, some of you out in the clinic here very shortly. As always, if you ever need anything, any of you, a letter of recommendation, assistance, advice on jobs, anything like that, feel free to contact any of us here at St. Ambrose. So once again, congratulations to you guys and good luck. Ashley Appleman. Ashley is from Urbandale, Iowa. She did her undergraduate studies at the University of Northern Iowa in movement and exercise science. Her post-graduation plans are working for Waverly Health Center in Waverly, Iowa. Ashley would like to say thank you. Congratulations, Ashley. Daniel Kashke. Dan is from East Moline, Illinois. He did his undergraduate studies at the University of Missouri, Columbia in health sciences. His post-graduation plans include being a member of the SAU residency program working at Rock Valley Physical Therapy. Dan would like to say, if the NPT exam questions were written by SAU faculty members, options would be A, it depends, B, it depends, but in caps. C, it depends, but written as a question. D, it depends, now written in quotes. Congratulations, Dan. Julia O'Connor. Julia is from Sherman, Illinois. She did her undergraduate studies at St. Ambrose University in exercise science. Her post-graduation plans include working in the St. Louis area. Julia would like to say, I'm thankful for the support I have received from my family, friends, and fellow PT students. I'm beyond grateful, and I'm so appreciative of the support and friendship from everyone during my studies. Thank you to everyone. Congratulations, Julia. Matthew Station. Matt is from Lynchfield, Minnesota. He did his undergraduate work at Bemidji State University in exercise science. Matt's postgraduate plans include working in the Twin Cities area. Matt would like to say, I would like to thank my family for supporting me throughout school. Congratulations, Matt.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on your graduation. You made it. I can't say enough about your class and everything that you have stepped up to the plate for, not only throughout your curriculum, but especially since March. In March, obviously you got interrupted in the middle of your 2-week clinical experience, but you got it. You understood the stakes and you stepped up to the plate and took the changes. You did anything you needed to get the job done. And that carried over to your long-term clinical experiences. I can't thank you enough for all of the flexibility that you showed, the last minute changes. Some of you had 3 clinical experiences canceled. Some of you had none, but you were ready to do what you needed to if they were canceled. And I can't thank you enough for that. I would like to commend you for everything you did to do your best in these long-term clinical experiences, for representing St. Ambrose in the best possible way. You made us proud. And I want to commend you for, as you go forward, I think what you'll get out of this experience is you've gained more resiliency. You've become even more flexible, and that is just going to make you a better therapist and help you as you go forward from here. So best of luck in the future. We are so proud of you, and look forward to seeing what you're going to do as a physical therapist. Congratulations and Merry Christmas.
Emma LeClaire. Emma is from Lino Lakes, Minnesota, and received her undergraduate degree in applied mathematics from the University of Minnesota in the Twin Cities. After graduation, she plans to work for Rock Valley Physical Therapy at PCI-ENT. Emma said, "I would like to thank my friends, classmates, family, and professors for supporting me through this program. I could not have done it without all of you." Emma Peeler. Emma is from Ames, Iowa, and received her undergraduate degree in exercise science and psychology from St. Ambrose University. After graduation, Emma plans to work in the Des Moines area in outpatient and in acute care. Emma said, "I would like to thank the professors and support staff of the SAU DPT program for educating me and providing me the opportunities and resources to be successful during PT school. I'd also like to thank my parents for their support for me and all my interests in schooling throughout my entire life. Good luck to all of you, my classmates and colleagues, as we all start our careers as physical therapists. We did it." DeAndre Small. DeAndre is from Bridgetown, Barbados. She received her undergraduate degree in health and human performance from the College of Idaho. She plans to work in the state of Florida after graduation. DeAndre said, "I would like to thank my parents for the sacrifices made to be able to get me this far and for their continuous support of my endeavors. I love you and appreciate you. I would also like to thank my study group who made studying less painful throughout PT school." Taylor Swanson. Taylor is from Plainfield, Illinois, and received her undergraduate degree in exercise science from Valparaiso University. Taylor plans to practice in home health care after graduation in the southwest suburbs of Chicago. Taylor said, "I'd like to thank my mom and dad for always supporting me, even when I went to college to study meteorology because I wanted to chase tornadoes."
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. Kaden even says congratulations. Good work, guys. I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of the resilience you guys have shown, especially completing your clinicals right now in the current environment we're in. You guys showed utmost flexibility with everything, with going online with different classes. So thank you for your patience with all the online learning. I appreciate all of your help along the way. You guys were my first class all the way through, so it was really fun to watch you guys grow, and you guys will always hold a special place in my heart. So I can't wait to see the awesome things that you guys do out there. To my colleagues, I look forward to interacting with you in the future, so please reach out if you need anything. Otherwise, I will catch you in the clinic someday. Congrats, guys.
Logan Bannon, his hometown is Louisville, Colorado. Completed his undergraduate degree at University of Colorado, majoring in integrative physiology. His post-graduation plans are to work in the Pacific Northwest. And Logan says, "Thank you to all my family and friends, especially my parents, who supported me along the way. I wouldn't have made it here without them. And thanks to my teachers, classmates, and the 25% who were always lifting each other up and building bonds for life. We did it." Sarah Scholl, her hometown is Mount Pleasant, Iowa. Her undergraduate degree was at Iowa State University, majoring in kinesiology. Her post-graduation plans are to work in the Marion-Cedar Rapids, Iowa area. And Sarah says, "Thank you to my mom and dad, husband, and the rest of my family and friends for all of your support along the way. A very special thank you to my husband and brother-in-law who are currently deployed overseas. I appreciate your service and sacrifice." Emily Stute, hometown is Elgin, Illinois. Her undergraduate degree was done at St. Ambrose University, majoring in exercise science. Her post-graduation plans are to work in acute or inpatient rehab neuro setting. And Emily says, "Mom, thank you for everything."
Hello, class of 2020. It's me again, but this time I'm wearing my faculty member hat. I want to say congratulations. I wish you the best of luck as you enter the workforce and start adulthood in a sense. It's so sad not being able to see you. Graduation is one of my favorite events of the year, where we get to visit with you and talk to you and meet your family and your friends and your significant others, all those things like that. Please do stop by and see us at some point once it's safe to do so. We want to celebrate with you somehow or another, and hope this video is a great way to do it. Best of luck to you. I know you guys will all go out and do great things. Tiffany Bertoni. Tiffany is from Springfield, Illinois. She received her undergraduate degree in biology from Augustana College. After graduation, she plans to work in the Kansas City, Missouri area. She would like to thank her parents and her grandparents for all their love and support. Colton Rule. Colton is from Omaha, Nebraska. He studied at the University of Nebraska in Omaha. Post-graduation, he plans on working in the Omaha, Nebraska area. He would like to thank his parents, Gary and Tina Rule, for their support and love they've provided throughout his journey. He'd also like to thank his sister, Marissa, for being an example of what an expert clinician is and providing him with guidance when he needed it. He'd also like to thank his girlfriend, Elise, for her support and patience during his journey through physical therapy school. Morgan Wheelwright. Morgan is from Elizabeth, Illinois. She received her undergraduate degree in mathematics from St. Ambrose University. After graduation, she plans on working in the Quad Cities area. She'd like to send a huge thanks to all of her professors and staff who helped her and support her during her time at St. Ambrose University.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. Can you believe that 2.5 years ago, you had no idea what benign paroxysmal positional vertigo is? And now you know what it is and you know what to do for it. Amazing. You've come so far in 2.5 years, and I'm amazed by the progress that you've made. I hope that you'll continue learning over the next 25 to 30 years. We miss you. It seems like so long since I've seen your faces. So I hope you'll stay in contact. Keep me updated on how you're doing. And I hope that you'll enjoy being a physical therapist as much as I do.
Alex Burley. Alex is from Davenport, Iowa, and received his undergraduate degree in exercise science from St. Ambrose University. After graduation, he plans on participating in the orthopedic residency program at Genesis. He'd like to thank both of his brothers, his fiancée Megan, and both of his parents for their constant support. Without them, he would not have made it through the program. He also wants to emphasize to Cody and Kyle that he is still Kevin's favorite.
Danielle Brzezinski. She is from Stevens Point, Wisconsin, and a University of Wisconsin lacrosse graduate in psychology. Her post-graduation plans are to work for Aspirus Wausau Hospital. She wants to thank all the professors and physical therapy department staff for their help and support over the past 2.5 years. She says that we have all played an essential role in sculpting exceptional physical therapists who will make a difference in the lives of our patients and community. She'd also like to thank her family and friends for their continued support to help her reach her goals and encourage her growth as a person and as a PT. Kim Shabino. She's an undergraduate of She's from Spencer, Iowa, and an undergraduate of Southwest Minnesota State University, exercise science. Post-graduation plans are to work in outpatient ortho. She wants to thank her parents, David and Stacy, for supporting her in various ways throughout her schooling. Caitlin Wright is from Princeton, Indiana. She's an undergraduate from Indiana University, Purdue University, Indianapolis, in exercise science. Post-graduation, she'll be applying to neurologic residency programs. She wants to thank her parents, siblings, her fiancé, the Garretts, and the Weises for all their love and support in helping her achieve this goal. She says, "We did it."
We did it. together celebrating, but just know I'm extremely proud of all of you and all that you've accomplished in the short 2.5 years of your time at St. Ambrose. Just think of what you're going to accomplish over the next 40 years as physical therapists. I'm really excited to see how you change the lives of many individuals who put their trust and their health in your hands. I want to compliment you on being the class of 2020, the flexible class of 2020. For all 36 of you were out on clinicals last March when things changed. I never had so many phone calls and emails in my life than I did the second and third week of March. Half of you got let go of your hospital or clinic site due to the first wave of COVID, and immediately the next day started over in a new site with full professionalism and flexibility. You all had to pivot very quickly. And for that, I thank you. I'm so happy to call you my colleagues. I'm very excited for your graduation and proud of you. God bless you along your next journey through the wide open doors of success and beyond. Well done, doctors of physical therapy. Well done.
Laura Moyer. Laura is from Sun Prairie, Wisconsin. She graduated undergrad from the University of Wisconsin, Stevens Point, majoring in biology. After graduation, she plans on working in inpatient rehabilitation in the Minneapolis area. Laura says, "A huge thanks to Bob, my husband, for being my biggest fan and supporter. I couldn't have done this without you." Kelly Mahosky. Kelly is from Stevens Point, Wisconsin. She graduated undergrad from the University of Wisconsin Parkside, majoring in applied health science. After graduation, she plans on working in the central Wisconsin area. She says thank you. Mallory Rettenmeyer. Mallory is from Aurora, Illinois. She graduated undergrad from St. Ambrose University, majoring in psychology. After graduation, she plans on working in a variety of settings almost anywhere. She says, "A hefty thanks to my mom for her muffins and editing. To my dad for answering all my adulting questions. My siblings for being incredible role models and cheerleaders. And my cohort for making PT school similar to childbirth. Forget the pain and only remember the joy that came with it." And Erin Sawatsky. Erin is from Bondurant, Iowa. She graduated from the University of Northern Iowa, majoring in biology. After graduation, she plans on working in the Des Moines, Iowa area. And Erin says, "Thank you to my family and friends."
We would like to recognize members of the class of 2020 who have won awards or received scholarships prior to tonight's graduation. The Rock Valley Physical Therapy Awards. Each year, guests instructors from Rock Valley Physical Therapy donate their speaking fees back to the Physical Therapy Department to recognize our students. The Rock Valley Physical Therapy Award recognizes students who have a strong commitment to the profession, are involved in student organizations, and have a record of service. The following students received this award in 2020: Danielle Brzezinski, Emma LeClaire, Mallory Rettenmeyer, and Caitlin Wright. Congratulations to these students. The Iowa Physical Therapy Foundation Scholarship. The Iowa Physical Therapy Foundation awards a handful of scholarships to physical therapy students each year. Students are chosen based on demonstrated scholarship, potential for professional contribution, and leadership qualities. This is a competitive scholarship process where every physical therapy student in the state of Iowa is eligible to apply for this award. This year, three students from St. Ambrose University were chosen for this honor: Cody Burley, Aaron Dunn, and Emma Peeler. Congratulations to these students.
Each year, the Physical Therapy Department recognizes a student who, in the opinion of the faculty, have met the following criteria: strong academic performance, consistently exhibited excellent professional behaviors, who is a role model through activities, leadership, and service, and has the potential to make contributions to the profession. For this award, we tend to pick a student who has not been recognized through other scholarships and awards to this point. Selection is difficult because we have so many very deserving students. This year, we chose a student who is consistently focused on learning, has excelled in the classroom and in her clinical experiences. She has served as a role model to her classmates and brings a positive demeanor to the class daily. The faculty feels certain that this student will go on and do great things in her career. It is with great pride we award the student scholarship to Anna Atkinson. Congratulations, Anna. Your award will be mailed to you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, families and friends, colleagues and peers, soon to be PTs. I'm Cody, and this up here, he's my buddy Dan. Everybody says I don't have a meme bone in my body, that I'm always politically correct, and my jokes are just dry puns that make everybody cringe because they're so punny it hurts. So I brought Dan along, who can help translate the speech into layman's terminology, who will unfold the true meanings held within tonight's message.
Hey everyone, I'm Dan. And for those of you who don't know, this up here is Dad. We are here to make you laugh, reminisce, and have a good time tonight. And most importantly, I'm here to make sure Cody's true thoughts and opinions are shared. After 2.5 years of working together, it is safe to say there is a deeper meaning behind Cody's words than meets the eye. And I hope to make that known to all of you here today.
Dan and I aren't going to give you new advice or words of wisdom that you haven't heard already. Rather, we're here to offer some times of reflection. The good, the bad, the funny, the sad, and to offer a good hearty laugh with some insight that has helped us get through our time here, that of which might help you in the next part of our journey.
Look, what Cody is trying to say is if we were the two people to give you all life advice, you'd walk away from graduation tonight dressed like a dad. You'd have your own personal belongings spread across three tables, also called Dan spreading, have a thoroughly constructed budget, and be ready to tell some witty puns. So let's get real. We're going to throw a little fun at our professors, at all of you, at ourselves, and in the meantime, find some closure and wisdom that won't pay you $1 million, but may help you as you start the next part of your life.
That being said, there's no better time than now to get started. So first up, we couldn't have done it without you, Kathy. You were the class mom. You mentored us on how to be good humans and helped us get through the hardest times. You showed us unconditional love while giving us the good old Irish kick in the butt when we needed it.
To translate for Cody here, Kathy, you really showed us how we shouldn't be throwing the baby out with the bathwater, and you always gave us the gestalt of the information. We may have started out as a bunch of ham hands, but we are walking away as skilled therapists, and for that, we will forever be in your debt.
And to Kevin, you did more than teach us musculoskeletal. You always checked in on us, made sure we were doing self-care, and taking time to enjoy life outside of PST school, while instilling in us the drive to be better than the average clinician in person.
Kevin, we hope you're enjoying this video from Colorado. You may be very gifted with your therapeutic touch in the clinic, but if you Google what not to do for nonverbal communication with your hands, your picture comes up. I'll be honest with you, we still don't know what snap, point, and whistle means.
And we could always count on you, Nora, for preparing us to think and work through any problem, related to the brain or not. Because you pushed us and challenged us, we grew more as students and clinicians than we ever thought we were capable of.
My translation cannot even really begin to explain the feelings packed behind that sentence that Cody just said. So I hope these memes help summarize Cody's thoughts better than I can.
Singing.
Us hands down the best preparation we could get to be successful with pediatrics. Thanks for your hard work putting together lab time with kiddos and helping us figure out how to interact with those tiny humans.
In other words, thanks to Katie, I now know where babies come from.
And to the jack of all trades, Carrie, it is evident that you always push yourself to know as much as you can about everything PTs do. This has been crucial to help educate us to be competent PTs in the future, and we greatly appreciate it.
Aside from that, you are also the inspiration behind our desire for head attire in the office, and I hope our future coworkers can appreciate the fashion trends you have bestowed upon us.
Dr. B, you have served as a great role model, demonstrating unparalleled commitment to the scientific process and research. You are more knowledgeable than anyone we have ever met when it comes to human anatomy.
Don't forget that Dr. B's taste in craft beers is also superb. Oh, and Dr. B, when do we get to learn the correct technique for the reverse scissor?
And to Kristen, thank you for your nurturing attitude, your willingness to always help, and always having an uplifting spirit every day. You helped us keep our heads high and our hearts in the right place, helping us get through hard times on clinicals and making sure that we knew we could get through anything.
Kristen, we waited for 2.5 years for you to goof up so we could poke fun at you during times like this, but somehow you managed to make it through unscathed. Congratulations, and thank you for your hard work.
And kudos goes to Lynn Frank. Honestly, I don't think anyone could have imagined what you have put up with this past year with COVID. Thank you for all the hard work you put into making sure we were all placed and were able to graduate on time this year, despite to the added challenges with COVID.
You still won't convince me to make up that week I missed a few months ago. That ship has sailed.
We learned how to do the best motivational interviews by none other than the pro himself, Mike. You have always held us accountable to take charge of our own education, made sure we had the core values of the SAU DPT program down to a T, and helped us figure out what it would take to get from a 7 out of 10 to a 10 out of 10 confidence level.
Mikey P, you're the man of many hats, with your most prominent hat being your meme-making abilities, and I hope you enjoy these. Your skills will not be forgotten.
And to Barb, thank you for bringing in expert physicians, teaching us how to collaborate and communicate in an effective manner that will productively advocate for our patients, and for ingraining us the lab and diagnostic values. These skills and knowledge base will help us to continue to develop as healthcare professionals.
Barb, you are the mastermind of delegation and you do it with the utmost class. So grab your glass of red wine and join us in saying cheers to the class of 2020.
And to Nicholas, your classes served as a foundation for the majority of our curriculum. We know you had a lot to cover, but you always pushed us to find only the best articles and how to interpret them for our own clinical use.
So in summary, read the titles for relevancy, read the abstract for authors' conclusions, make clinical decisions based on the summary. Easy as 1, 2, 3, and all thanks to you, Nicholas.
Dana, you helped us to reflect and grow both personally and professionally, gave us a multitude of current resources and best practices for pain management, and encouraged us to always step outside of our comfort zone to grow as people and as clinicians.
As much as we've all grown in our time in the program, nothing compares to Dana's growth and her ability to pull down the projector screen on her first attempt almost every time.
And to Priscilla, I don't know if you will be watching this, but from the bottom of our hearts, thank you for the hard work you did to prepare for CAPTI. We just found out we passed. Woohoo! We know it was not easy, but we know you gave it everything you had, so thank you.
Never mind, I find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I'm glad I'll remember you say. Sometimes it lasts a love, but sometimes it hurts instead.
The music said it all. And to the front office staff, your selfless work never goes unnoticed, and you are always willing to help in any way that you can. Thanks for making PT school possible for us and doing all the behind the scenes work. We are forever grateful.
Your candy was the life force of surviving PT school, and we could not have made it to the end without your candy sugar highs. So thank you.
Many people made this dream come true for us, and many still have not been recognized yet in the speech, but we need them to know that they are deeply appreciated for everything that they have done for us, including but not limited to our family, our roommates, our amazing lab assistants like David, Jill, Megan, and Liz, our better halves, our clinical instructors, and our patients, all who were willing to take a chance on us throughout this process.
Don't forget the bartenders and the people who had to listen to us sing on Friday nights at karaoke.
Amen. And of course, all of you.
The student gang.
Remember day one, walking into the building, not knowing what the future was really going to hold? Well, look at us now. We've come full circle. We're about to walk out those same doors we came in, well, figuratively speaking, thanks to COVID, only to go through another new set of doors out into the world, not fully knowing what to expect yet again.
It seems like just yesterday we were getting to class early to start the semester off so we could pick out our unassigned seats. We were sitting in the lab rooms eating our annual Thanksgiving meal and getting in our steps every 50 minutes around CHSE to try and wake ourselves up a bit.
Looking back, I don't think a day passed throughout PT school where we didn't feel a roller coaster of emotions, like the excitement to become a PT, all the self-doubt that we'd never make it to this point, the pure exhaustion from hours of studying for exams and practicals, practicing manual skills, completing all those homework assignments for weeks on end, and the paradox of desiring for PT school to end while at the same time dreading the end of it, because that meant we'd have to say goodbye and start over in the world.
While COVID may have caused us to miss out on more memories made together as a class, and maybe we did not get the closure we were all hoping for, but we did accomplish quite a bit in the time we had together and persevered through this last year to get where we are today as graduates. We were mentored from clinicians and professors that truly cared about us and our patients. They made sure we were ready to be the best possible clinicians we could be. Most importantly, the friendships we built will last a lifetime. And I truly mean that.
I think it goes without saying that the last 2.5 years have been a whirlwind and have been worth all the blood, sweat, and tears that have gone into making it today. We all overcame the adversities in our lives to make it here. We did get to finish PT school. We had professors that were willing to put together a virtual graduation celebration for us. And now we get to take the next steps to becoming professionals.
All that being said, it's time to wrap up. And we want to leave you with two quotes. The first series is by Patch Adams, where he says, "See what no one else sees. See what everyone chooses not to see, out of fear, conformity, or laziness. See the world anew each day. And if you treat a disease, you win, you lose. You treat a person, I guarantee you'll win, no matter what outcome." In these quotes, Patch challenges us to be different, be somebody who strives to develop oneself personally and professionally every day, and to avoid becoming a cookie cutter PT, to dig deeper than the problem at hand and seek out the solution, and to always, always keep the patient first.
And the last quote we want to give you is by Brené Brown, a researcher, writer, storyteller, and social worker. And it comes from her book, Daring Greatly. She quotes a speech given by Theodore Roosevelt, which we hope inspires you to dig deep, be vulnerable, and be a damn good PT. The quote goes like this: "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to a man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly." So now it's time to get your hands dirty. It's time to go out there and be who you are meant to be, whatever that may look like. It's time to fall down and get back up again. It's time to be vulnerable and show compassion in all that you do.
Our hope is that you all remain true to yourselves. Keep ingrained why you became a PT and never stop learning. We know that the education you received here at St. Ambrose has prepared you to take on anything you might experience as practicing clinicians. You all will be amazing, competent, empathetic, and effective leaders in whatever you do. And don't forget that.
SAU DPT class of 2020, congrats on making it to the start of our careers. We have reached the light at the end of one tunnel and are getting ready to enter another. Many people use graduation as the chance to close one door and open another. As far as Dan and I are concerned, we hope that you consider keeping this door open, leaving the opportunity available for us all to come visit and catch up down the road when life allows it. May we find joy and meaning in the years to come through our careers as PTs and whatever else crosses our paths in life. Well done, champs. You made Dad proud.
in all seriousness, we miss you all, and we hope nothing but the best for all of you as you begin the next chapter of your life. We share a bond and friendship that is stronger than anyone could have imagined. We may not have gotten the ending we wanted, but I think we can all say we got the friendships we never knew we needed. Now, before we turn the page one final time as classmates, let's look back at some of the moments we have shared together along this unbelievable journey.
This brings our ceremony to a close. To the class of 2020, you've completed your transition from students into graduates, and in a short time, you'll be full members of the physical therapy profession. I'm proud to call each of you my colleagues. While we talk tonight about some funny and touching memories from your education, do not forget to always listen to others, learn through your experiences, and love what you're doing. I challenge each of you to embrace new opportunities for growth and development in your professional career, but also in your personal life. Finally, I challenge you to be a leader. We need leaders who are ready to tackle the important issues in our society, and it will help optimize healthcare. You are all leaders in different ways, and I hope you continue to see yourselves in that way. Thank you to the graduates for choosing St. Ambrose University. I also want to say thank you to the family and friends of our graduates. Without your love and support, the students would not be here tonight. We do hope to see you in the near future. Please stop by and visit once it is safe to do so. Also know that we hope to have some sort of face-to-face celebration with your class in the future. Once again, congratulations. Go Bees!